And it's Friday, and that's the preparation day, and tomorrow we're going to worship together again, and I'm excited about that and looking forward to sharing that time with you. On Wednesday, we looked at the healing of the nobleman's son, who took Jesus at his word when he announced from a distance of 20 miles that the nobleman's son would live. Now we come to the centurion's son. So we're looking at leaders, not disciples, but leaders. And the centurion has come to Jesus. We read about this one in Matthew chapter 8, beginning with verse 5. When Jesus had entered Capernaum, and I love Capernaum. I've been there. I love to just bask in the ruins of the synagogue that Jesus taught in there. I'm going back next February, and I would love to have some of you come with me. I'm going to have some brochures on the welcome desk again this Sabbath. So think about it. You will never regret seeing these places. Jesus had come to Capernaum, and a centurion, the leader of 100 men, came to him asking for help. Lord, he said, my servant. Now, the nobleman came for his son. The centurion comes for his servant. He lies at home paralyzed, and he's suffering terribly. And Jesus said to him, shall I come and heal him? And the centurion replied, Lord, I don't deserve. I'm not worthy for you to come to my home, to come under my roof. If you would just say the word. Now, I wonder if he had somehow made connection with a nobleman and knew, but he had faith. If you would just say the word, my servant will be healed. I myself am a man of authority. And when I give a command, it is obeyed. When I say come, they come. If I say do this, it is done. When Jesus heard the centurion say this, it says he was amazed, and he said to those who were following him, truly I tell you, I have not found anyone in Israel with such great faith. And I say to you that many will come from the east and the west and will take their places at the feast with Abraham. People are going to come from way outside my chosen people. People are going to come from way outside our denomination. People are going to come from way outside the Christian church structure and sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the subjects of the kingdom, many of them will be thrown outside into darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Whoa. Just being in the church is not enough. We have to be in Christ. And if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation, and Christ will come and be in him. That's the difference. Being in the church, being in the right church, that's not enough. We must be in Christ. And then Jesus said to the centurion, and go and let it be done just as you believed it would, just as you had the faith to believe. Go and it will be done. And his servant was healed at that moment. So another leader coming with a request, first for a son, now for a servant. But this one came believing that Jesus could just simply give the command, and it was done. Both tremendous acts of faith. The nobleman believed and went home. The centurion believed and came to Jesus and said, just please, just say the word. God is able to do amazing things. Will you come to him believing that he is able to do in you what he has promised to do? That's the key. In the meantime, God bless.